Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world. This is The World Away and this is a quick video today. This is complementing stage 24 of the Agora Models Jaguar build. We're going to finish the tyre off by doing the third and fourth row of spokes. Now we're going to have to do this five times, so I've created these videos so you can refer back to them to see how to do them. But in the second row of spokes, at the end of it, it's going to look just like this. Matter of fact, this probably needs a little bit of cleaning. It's got my fingerprints all over it. But I'm about to show you now exactly how we got to this stage. So at the end of the last stage, this is where we're up to, and this is what your wheel should look like there. What we're going to be doing now is we're going to be putting the spokes in that go from this side through to the other side here that cross over in the middle. So to do that, the first thing we need is pack A. We don't want to confuse these spokes. So pack A is the first ones that we're going to use, and I'll get all of these out. Now I have zoomed up my camera quite a way. We don't need any jigs for this. In the inside here, you've got a row of circles that are in the very bottom and a row of circles that are at the very top. So the bottom ones are the inners, the top ones are the outers, and these A's are going to go into the inners. Now they're going to go through the hole, and they're going to go through the little triangular hole, and I'll show you a picture of this that we can see there. So let's get these in and do the bottom row first. Tweezers will be your friend on this. So as you can see, they fit underneath just like that. So we're going to repeat that all the way around, making sure that when we put them in, we're missing one of the triangle sections we're putting this through and putting it in the following one. So we're alternating them. So when they're all in, they should look like that on top. And as you can see, they're all coming out the bottom there. And now what we're going to do is we're going to be doing exactly the same thing with the B spokes, but this time they're going to go into the outside. And they're going to go into all the triangles that we haven't put a spoke in at the moment, but they're going to cross over the spokes that we've just put in. So let's do that now. So I'll put one in there, just down the bottom, so you can see how that goes. And I'm going to repeat that for all the rest. So when that's done, as you can see, they've all crossed over in there. They're absolutely perfect, but they're all hanging down the bottom. So now we're going to connect these up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get myself some blue tack. And I've rolled this into kind of like a little slug shape. I'm going to push that down here just to keep those pins into place so I can turn it over and we can see all of those pins on top there. So when I turn it over, I'm going to be putting on this metal ring now. So there is a little hole in here, as you can see just at the top, which is going to match the hole that we've got on this side here. So let's put that over the top and make sure that's all pushed down. Perfect. Now what I'm going to do now is I want to start putting all of these metal spokes, exactly like you saw in the stage previous to this, around the larger of the plastic parts here. So when I put this time on, it's going to clamp them all into place. So let's do that now. You can actually see the indents around the teeth that we put these in. They are actually the smaller ones, not the larger ones. It's the smaller ones, and they fit completely into those indents. I'm going to do that all the way around. So when they're in, they should look just like that. That does take a lot of time to get them in place, but now we're in a position to put this top on. And again, where that hole is there with the lug going through, we're going to match that up on the same side here. So it's going to go into that point just there. And I'm just checking all of that. It looks like it's clamped together very well. Excellent. So now we can put screws in here, which are AGO-free and hold all of that together. So once they're perfectly in position, you put the top on, secure it down with the four screws, and that is completed. So that is the finished wheel, and you're going to have to do that four more times. But it is all ready now for the tire to go over the top. So there you go. That's one complete rim. Obviously, the tires going over the top of it's quite the easy bit compared to what we've just had to do. But refer back to this when I'm doing these packs, because I won't have to film this each time. I do this normally in one go, and believe me, it gets easier. I've done two now, and I found that a lot easier than when I did the first one. But I hope that's helped you out. I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.